Hello everyone, my name is Anita Singh, your science teacher from Sri Rama Bharti Public School. Today, again I will discuss few of the topics from the chapter Cell Structure and Function. So, let's start. Now, today we will discuss about plant cell and animal cell. Right? Today we will discuss about plant cell and animal cell. As you can see clearly, the plant cell and animal cell. And there are few cell organelles which are present in both plant cell as well as animal cell, like cytoplasm, like endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, nucleolus, and vacuole, mitochondria, and cell membrane. These are present in both the cells. But there are few differences also. We will discuss later on. First of all, we should know a cell has both living and non-living parts. A cell has both living and non-living parts. All plant and animal cells consist of three basic components. Number one, cell membrane, also known as plasma membrane. Number two, cytoplasm, in which all cell organelles are embedded. And number three is nucleus, the brain of the cell. So these are the three basic parts, or we can say the basic components of a unique cell. Cell membrane, also known as plasma membrane, then cytoplasm, and then nucleus. Now it's very important to learn the main differences between plant cell and animal cell. Like the plant cell. Plant cells always they are having cell wall. Cell wall is a non-living part because it is made up of cellulose. So cell wall is present in plant cell, but cell wall is absent in animal cell. Second thing, plastids. We all know plastids are present in plant cell, but in animal cell, plastids are absent, like chloroplast, chromoplast, leucoplast. These are the plastids which are present in plant cell, but plastids are absent in animal cell. Then comes the plant cell has a large vacuole, but in animal cell, vacuoles are either absent, or if they are present, they are very small in size. Centrosomes. Centrosomes are absent in plant cell, but centrosomes are present in animal cell. Then comes lysosomes. Lysosomes are absent in plant cell, but lysosomes are present only in animal cells. And the last difference is plant cell is larger than animal cell and has a regular shape, but animal cell is smaller and irregular in shape. So these were the main differences between plant cell and animal cell. Now we will learn about prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Now, what is prokaryotic cell? The nuclear material is not surrounded by nuclear membrane in prokaryotic cells. So, means in such cells which lack a nuclear membrane are called prokaryotic cells. And the organisms with prokaryotic cells are called prokaryotes. Like the main examples are bacteria and blue-green algae. Bacteria and blue-green algae are prokaryotes. Now, eukaryotic cells. The cells which have a well-organized nucleus means it is having nuclear membrane. So, these type of cells are known as eukaryotic cells. And the organisms with eukaryotic cells are known as eukaryotes. Most of the plants and animals, they are eukaryotic cells, except bacteria and blue-green algae. All organisms other than bacteria and blue-green algae are called eukaryotes. So, I hope you are able to understand each and every topic properly. So, it's time to say goodbye. Have a nice day. Bye, everyone.